remains a sore point for SADC. The main issue of discontentment being the implementation of Judge Mpapi Pumapi Commission's recommendations. It investigated the violence that engulfed the Mountain Kingdom. The Lesotho government has been urged to urgently fulfill her commitments through demonstrable implementation of SADC decisions.
They have presented already a program, a security sector reform program, and a concept note for the constitutional reforms. That's why they even requested for further support from SADC, that now, since we have submitted these two key documents, how can you support us further?
Some of the changes they have to make are administrative. Some of them are constitutional.
South Africa's Deputy President Cyril Ramaphosa will continue to facilitate peace efforts in Lesotho.
The government of Lesotho has really taken on all the recommendations. They are working on them. There was nothing for us to feel. There was anything untoward. I think they've accepted, and that to me indicates the commitment of the Lesotho government to bring about peace and stability in Lesotho.
But a group of 30 Lesotho opposition parliamentarians paint a different picture of Lesotho. They were not given an audience at the summit and were told to leave the venue.
The situation in Lesotho was never one of violence in the streets and people running amok. It has been a significant and general discontentment of the people with the political situation in Lesotho, and that remains the situation today.
SADC wants tangible progress on security and constitutional reforms in Lesotho during the next summit in August. Tsholofelo Mathibedi, SABC News, Gaborone.